Good evening, this is Kanzonomy. Today we're going to do a comparison of my Zeiss Ikon box tengor, which is on my left, and the Kodak number 2 Brownie Model F on the right. This video will go over their differences and their similarities. The first similarity, as you can see, is that they're both, well, box-shaped. That's because they are both box cameras. But largely, that is where the similarities end. Yes, they both have brilliant viewfinders. Yes, they both have a lens. Yes, they both have winding mechanisms. And yes, you could say they both have bulb mode and an instant mode. But that's really about it. In terms of their actual aims, they really couldn't be much more different, as well as in terms of their operation. The first major difference is that the Zeiss winds from the top and the Brownie winds on the bottom. This winder in and of itself has differences as well. The winder on the Brownie simply winds forever and doesn't do any other function besides wind film on. In theory, if I had film in here, I could simply wind forever and have the film go from one end to the other. On the box tengor, the winding mechanism does wind the film, but it also enables the shutter. So the winding key does in fact do something else besides merely wind the film on. It gets the shutter ready for the next exposure. This brings me to my next difference between the box tengor and the Brownie. The Brownie, I'll just move the box over for a second, has a shutter mechanism that can be activated as many times as you want. You could theoretically do an infinitesimal exposure if you chose to do this forever. The box tengor, on the other hand, has a shutter mechanism that only allows for one actuation, and you cannot activate it again. There is a built-in double exposure blocking device. Right there, this camera, the box tengor, is more advanced than the Brownie. The next big difference between the Zeiss and the Brownie is the Zeiss has zone focusing. Here, we see it's at 6 feet to 3 feet. From 20 feet to 6 feet, and 20 feet to infinity. On the other hand, there is no focusing ability on the Brownie number 2. You simply point, aim, and hope your subject is somewhere between, I would say, 8 feet and infinity. Another difference: the box tengor has actual apertures. The widest opening is f9. There's also f11 and f16. Now, the Brownie has a maximum opening of f16 and goes down to f32, but it is controlled by a tab up here and the f-stops are not clearly labeled. The bulb function on the box tengor is also plainly labeled as T for a timed exposure, which I have set it to. And I'm going to release the shutter. And I can hold it open as long as I want. And then close it. The Brownie is the same way. It's up here for a time release. And you would do the same thing. The cameras also open differently to take film. The Brownie's release is by pulling and turning the rewind lever, pulling the back door flap down, and simply pulling the cartridge at the back of the camera, like so. You would load the film on, put the cartridge back in, in, drop the cartridge, close the back, and put the winding knob back in. The box tengor, on the other hand, does not have a back door that opens. You have to pull this knob and then force the two halves apart. Hold on and I'll show you. So as you can see, the tengor is now open. We can see where the spool for taking up the film is. The loading spool would be on the bottom. The handle does not come apart, so that's why I kind of flipped the front half onto the back half. And one other thing to point out while this is open is the tengor has a shutter interlock that prevents you from accidentally shooting if you don't want to shoot. A little feature that I happen to think goes a long way if you're traveling with one of these. Now, perhaps the biggest difference that's immediately visible is that the lens structure. Both of these are considered meniscus lenses. That means they're shaped in some way convex in the front or back, and concave on the other side. Think of it kind of like a backwards C. The Brownie has a single element lens. It's not achromatic, and it's literally just one lens, element shaped into a meniscus. The Zeiss has a Garris Frontar achromat, which is a meniscus lens, but it's made out of two different types of glass that are designed to reduce diffraction, aberrations, and other issues that typically plague box cameras. To that end, the outcome of the tengor is potentially much higher than that of the Brownie. In addition, the tengor is from the mid-50s, and its lens is coated, which allows it to work better with color films. The Brownie, being from the 1920s, is not coated, and was largely designed for the black and white emulsions of its time. So now that I've given a brief comparison of both cameras, one thing I will say that works in the favor of the Brownie is the ease of use and the ease of being able to quickly open it, pull out the cartridge, put the film on, put it back in. The viewers are much smaller than on the tengor as well, and there are things the tengor does not lack. For example, the tengor has an external shutter release over here, the ability to take a flash sync over here, but the Brownie has two tripod mounts, one here and one down there, whereas the tengor only has one mount down there. The tengor, though, does feel much more put together. It feels much more solid in hand. It doesn't feel as chintzy, for lack of a better term. But at the same time, I feel that the Brownie better captures the spirit and intent of a box camera. With that being said, it really depends on what my intention of shooting would be. Do I want to shoot for the best of the best within the box class, or do I just want to be able to shoot for the hell of it? This has been a comparison of the Zeiss Ikon Box Tengor and the Kodak number 2 Brownie Model F. They both shoot 120 film, both produce 6x9 negatives. I guess that's a similarity I left out. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is Ganzonomy. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, please do stay safe and have a good night. Thank you.